What's going on, everyone? Welcome back. Today we're in Prior Lake, Minnesota, getting ready to check out another beautiful home from another brand new builder. Say hello to 6144 Broadview Drive and just get a load of the colors on this home. It just looks fantastic. Now, this home is designed by David Charles, who's the architect, and it was built by JB Woodfitter Homes. So beautiful home. I love the board and batten right here with like this really cool looking siding. This is actually called AZAC cladding, which is cool. Kind of like that wood color. And I'll give you a little closer look as we get up to it. I just think it looks really, really neat. Bunch of different colors happening around this home. Now, this home does feature 5 bedrooms, 7 bathrooms, a 4-car garage, and all of that sits inside of approximately 5,200 square feet. It is currently listed for $2.3 million. And if you are interested in this home, you can click the link right there at the top of the description, or you can go over to roofealty.com. So this is kind of that cladding I was talking about. It looks like wood, almost like a deck board type material. You just don't ever have to paint it. So that's pretty neat. But with that, let's go ahead and get inside and see what all we can find. All right, here we go. Man, another home with another beautiful view. You got that lake back there. Another kind of wetland preserve, which is pretty neat. Beautiful living room. Oh my goodness. Let me go ahead and turn you around real quick before we get too far into it. Let you check out the front entryway. So this is your front door right here. Huge foyer. You've got this little catwalk up above it, which is pretty neat. And it's like it's open on either side. Like the foyer is two-story open to above, which is neat. Gorgeous light fixture hanging down in the middle of this stairwell going both up to the second floor and down to the basement. All right, so before we get too far into the main home, let's go ahead and start over here. This is actually like the pool room. So this is gonna be like the first bathroom we come to, which it's a full bathroom. It's got the single vanity right here with this nice dark color, kind of a cool looking pendant light hanging down with the bowl, some fun wallpaper. You got some shiplap. And then around the corner, you've got this standalone shower, nice dark shower tray with almost like the river rock. I guess I need to open up the door, huh? I got a little bit of a glare there, but almost like the river rock shower tray. Kind of like taking, even with the wallpaper, it's like taking a shower in the jungle. Kind of the vibes that I get from it. But then just off, like beyond that, you've got a pocket door and then kind of like stackable washer and dryer and a little bench. Now that's because eventually there's still, the weather didn't quite work out in their favor since we are in Minnesota, you know, coming out of winter. But this, there would be a pool right here, which is, and then from the pool, you can come in here, kind of wash off, you know, all the chlorine or salt, whatever type of pool you end up having. But that's pretty neat. And then all the way at the end of this little hallway is, probably could be a bedroom. It's going to be used as an office. This home is already sold. So this is just, an idea generator, and you can kind of see what builders and architects are capable of in different areas. But nice big room, kind of set off into the corner, which is cool. And then this right here is its closet, so you've got some nice built-ins. That is the one thing I do love about touring all these parade homes. We don't see any more wire shelves, you know what I mean? Which is probably like the biggest, probably the biggest comment that I would see from you guys saying is just wire shelves. They don't belong in a house. But they have their place. There's different price points for everyone, I think. And maybe that, if that helps someone afford a cool home, You know what I mean? I can't really knock it. But I like this bathroom. I like the white and the kind of gold trim. That looks pretty neat. Another cool shower tray. That one's got like the herringbone pattern to it with the little itty bitty tiles. A lot of wood in here. I like that too. It's got a real modern vibe to the whole home, but then this wood kind of brings, you know, nature inside, which is neat. And of course the floors. The floors are absolutely gorgeous. I love the wide planks. I think that looks fantastic. But then we come into the great room, two-story, with the nice vault, the exposed beams, whew, and that massive chandelier right there. That looks awesome. You got the fireplace with the stone going all the way up to the ceiling as well. Let me back you up a little bit so you can kind of check that out. But then on either side, you've got some room for some built-ins. Nice toasty fireplace. And then I'll go ahead and turn you around, give you views back into the kitchen. Now right here, you would have the sliding glass doors would open up onto a back patio or porch, which would be pretty neat. And then kind of a fun layout for the kitchen. So you've got this great big island with seats that kind of wrap around two sides. I think that's a little bit of a first. We'll get into some drawers real quick. Soft close, of course. You've got the built-in microwave. And then a couple little outlets on this side. And then along the back wall, we've got double ovens. The range hood, which is pretty neat, kind of keeps with that board and batten theme, but then also with the wood. It's a little unique. It's like a tri-color kind of thing, but it works really well together. And then you've got the gas range, and then next to that is this huge refrigerator, which is pretty cool. Oop, don't look at the pantry. The pantry's nice too. But, and then on the far side, you've got the sink, which is kind of a unique metal. I don't know what you would call it, but it looks cool. But that would be looking out into your side yard and kind of that back patio porch area with the fireplace. Ooh, some snickety snacks. And then you come into the dining room. It's got, well, I guess the whole kitchen. Let me back up. It does have, the whole kitchen, it's got like this tray ceiling that goes from the kitchen itself all the way here into the dining room. But I love this. 180 degrees of windows. You've got another set of sliding doors back behind the dining room table, which is cool. Another fun light fixture hanging down over the top of the table itself. Get you over here so you can check this out. Just get all the good views, the different angles and stuff of the home. And then we'll go ahead and pop out here onto this patio area. Now this will have those automatic screens, you know, with the remote stuff. It looks like another screened door right here. But my favorite part is this fireplace. Just come out here and hang out. Looks like there'll be a TV up there. And you could just be enjoying the fireplace while taking in the view. That's probably what I wanna know. Like, what is your favorite place? And you can answer this down in the comments. What is your favorite place in a home? Right? If you just were to purchase a home, what is your favorite place that you would want to hang out all the time? I know there's tons of different possibilities, you know what I mean? But kitchen would probably be a big one. this cool pantry right here would probably be one. I don't know. For me, maybe. Maybe not for me. But this would be cool. Like, this is where you put all the snacks. So, I mean, honestly, this is probably where everybody's going to be hanging out. You do have another dishwasher in here. I do like that. Kind of like a cool sink right there. It's pretty neat. I love the floating shelves. And, of course, you've got the pocket door that separates it. And then it just kind of L's around. You go take this little hallway back out to the foyer, but we're going to keep just working our way down through here. See what all we can find. Kind of like a coat closet, maybe like a cleaning closet. And it's not really going to be a coat closet, I don't think, because you've got all those lockers and stuff back there. But then you have the powder room with a floating vanity. That's pretty nice. Another storage room. Tons of built-ins. A lot of storage, it seems like, throughout this home, too. It's literally just everywhere. And then all the way at the end of this hall, you come to the mud room, which means we're pretty close to the garage. So this looks out onto the front porch. Nice little bench. And then all of the cubby space. And then some fun light fixtures up there as well. Little drop zone area so you can drop your keys, your bills. Ooh, all right. It's a lot of space in here. Nice big garage. Single door, double door, and then over here you've got another door. Is that like a, got another TV jack out here? I don't know if you can see it right there. That's pretty cool. Come hang out with your baby. By baby, I mean car. Watch some football. Something along those lines. I don't know. I've never seen a TV jacking up in a garage before. But anyway, all right. Let's go upstairs. It's easier to come down two flights of stairs than it is to walk up two flights of stairs. So, super fun light fixture. That thing just goes. Now, I have not at all been up here. I did go down to the basement just to kind of scope that stuff out. So, to prevent us from getting too lost, we will head down this way. It looks like a laundry room. Kind of a cool view. Back down into the great room. You got the double doors that open up into the laundry room. That's pretty nice. Though the laundry room is on the second floor. Of course, you still have stackable washer and dryers up or down on the main floor as well, but this laundry room it's kind of separate from all the bedrooms. So tons of counter space. Do some, get your folding on. Nice big wash basin. I like the color too. Kind of like an olivey color. Maybe a mossy color. And then let's see. A little unfinished. Well, it's pretty much finished. Just need some floors, but maybe like a big closet. Another storage room. I think there's, like I said, there's a lot of storage in this home. Just in different areas. There's quite a bit downstairs too. And then on the opposite side, it just kind of goes everywhere you turn your head. It's got something. All right, I think we've entered the master bedroom. So this is the closet. Nice big built-ins everywhere. Got some carpet. Feels good on my feet. Had to take the shoes off. I was walking around in the dirt outside a little bit. And then into the room itself. Again, nice vaulted ceiling, huge beam. Nice light fixture. Hear the geese out there. We've got a kind of private balcony, which is pretty neat. Definitely hang out here. And I like it because you've just got this door and this great big picture window. And then like a little littler window, but I like the big picture window. I think that looks pretty neat. A little sitting area over here. And then into the ensuite. Nice big built-in just as soon as you walk in. Ooh. So double vanities, some fun sconces. And then this shower. Ooh. That's real nice. So zero threshold as you walk into the shower. Nice ledge, got a bench towards the back. A really pretty tile. And then you've got two rainfall shower heads. Nice transom window. And then you have this soaking tub right here that you can just sit in, take in the view. I think there's also, it's all about taking views in up here too. So not only you got storage, you got plenty of like hangout areas just to be outside and enjoy that. But literally like every room has a view. Except for this one up here. It seems to sit up towards the front of the house. But you got a little spot right here. Looks like could be a cool spot for like a little reading nook or something. Put like some fluffy rugs, maybe a beanbag chair or something there. And then this room sits up towards the front of the house as well. This one's got like fun little turns and nooks and crannies and stuff. Into its closet. Now this is different. I want to make sure I'm not missing anything. So this bedroom shares the bathroom with the hallway, it looks like. So you've got the shower and tub. Kind of a, it's got a removable shower head within the bigger shower head. And that's cool. Nice big tub. And then double vanities. Oh, I think it's kind of like a Jack and Jill. You got the toilet. Nice. Just kind of a funky Jack and Jill. A linen closet or cabinet. Is this a hamper? Yeah, that's cool. Nice way to store it. So you could go out into the hallway where you have access straight into the bedroom from right here in the bathroom. We're just gonna go into the hallway so we can, I guess it really didn't matter, but you know, whatever. Just to kind of give you an idea as far as where we're at and orient yourself. Ooh, that's a pretty picture right there on the wall. Nice big room though. Again, tons of windows. Check out that picture. That would definitely be a nice view to wake up to every morning. But a lot of light, a lot of natural light coming through those windows. Got a step-in closet, again, plenty of built-ins. They go down a little ways, not too far, on either side. And then this is all the way at the end of the hall. So this is nothing more, or I don't want to say nothing more. That's, I shouldn't say that. But it's a game room. It's not a bedroom. That's what I meant to say. Like, it's not a bedroom, but this could be like a game room, den area, craft room, school room, tons of possibilities. What would you do up here? It's got the carpet in here too. I think all the rooms pretty much had carpet. It kind of feels, you know, sometimes I take my shoes off, sometimes I don't. Just depends on, you know, the nature of the tour that we're doing. But I have to tell you, the carpet feels good compared to like the hardwoods. Obviously, hardwood's probably gonna be a little easier to keep clean, but you're gonna spend a lot more time cleaning it, for one, because at least carpet hides stuff. You know what I mean? So with these hardwoods though, man, you see the dirt. Not right now, I'm just saying in general. But transitioning from hardwood to carpet, yeah, carpet just feels good. All right, coming down here to the basement level. Can't even call it a basement because it is far from a basement. This is a full-on sanctuary. And it's got quite a bit of rooms kind of coming off of it, a little different things shooting off of it. Let's do the bar area real quick. And then we've got this section to get into, and then we're gonna do all the stuff back behind us. So great big island right here. We got the wet bar back behind it, plenty of space for seating. Oop, don't knock down the picture. Oh man, that would be horrible. So the last time I was walking around and I was just, it's got a powder room back behind the kitchen. I was filming in the living room and I was turning to pan back towards like the dining room and kitchen area. And I just heard this gigantic crack. Well, that's sketch. I'm like, oh my goodness, what happened? Like, honestly though, it like scared me. Like I was like, ooh, there's a ghost in the house. You know what I mean? Sorry, I gotta tell the story, but I gotta keep moving. You know what I mean? Nice, like a hammered copper sink. Pretty neat, I like that. Floating shelves. But yeah, it scared the mess out of me. And it was ended up being a mirror that fell in the powder room. So this is going to be a gun room, which is pretty neat. I would like to have one of those myself. I've just got I've got my gun safe where we keep everything, but I don't have a full-on like gun safe room. It's basically my office. We call it the war room. Because not only does it have all my firearms, but it also has, you know, like we're going businessy things happen in there sometimes. Other times the baby's in there making a mess. But anyway. All right, we're going to go ahead and head on over here. And looks like we've got the utility closet. Humongous water heater. Got the furnace. Sump pump back behind us. Or no, those are just water lines. Just kidding. And then this is just storage up underneath of the stairwell. and then some more kind of fun space to do whatever you wanted to do with it. And then around the corner is another powder room. So another single vanity with the light fixture and the toilet. All right, and then getting back down into here, you've got a raised bar over here with a lot more seating, which is pretty neat because if you're watching a game or a movie or something like that, you've got even more space to kind of hang out. Another little carpety section. Nice big built-in right below the TV. With some fun batting strips. And then we've got, what is this? Another room. So you got your egress. A lot of space in here. Into its closet, also step in. And then into the ensuite. I like this. I like the open idea of a linen closet here within the bathroom itself. We've got the single vanity, the toilet, and then this nice standalone shower again. It's a darker shower tray, but it's got like the white little circle tiles, which is pretty neat. And then we've got one more little space. What is behind this door? Ooh, it's so dark. Oh, more storage. Tons of storage. Let me turn you around so you can get like the full view. A lot of room. Man. All right, let me know what you think about this home down in the comments. If you are interested in a home like this, you can go over to roofealty.com. Tell us a little bit about yourself, what you're looking for. That way we can help connect you with a real estate agent in your area that can help you find a home like this or just your dream home in general. Our whole goal here is to help you dream it through these tours and then to help you find it and eventually hear about how much you love it. Maybe you'll even let me come and tour it one day. Anyway, with that though, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I certainly did. As always, my name is Timothy. I look forward to seeing your beautiful face in the next one, which is going to be, I got two more to do today. Anyway.